Stand up.
If you have
stand up.
Said that the young
if
people
are mother crying for your child,
and God, the young people
stand
up. Never before.
If you're young,
for the enemy is on attack,
and you want to pull down
pressure, I pray that this whole type of God rises.
Stand
I pray against the shootings in our schools.
Stand
I pray against for them, good or bad. I have learned right now to just pray for them.
I don't argue with them no more. I don't fight with them no more. I just pray for them. I pray for everybody's children that's around me, that I touch, any family that I go through. I pray for their kids, because I would love this world to be a better place for our children. Because the way I grew up and the way these kids are growing up is totally different. You know, so it's hard. You know, when you have a child, you carry it for 9 months, you go through that horrifying pain, and then even though you watch them grow and grow, you want them to be a nurse, you want them to be a doctor, you want them to be a teacher, you want them to do the best thing, but then they decide they want to do something else. And sometimes we have kids that end up in the system, and we fight and we fight and we fight, you know, they're innocent, but sometimes God put them there for a reason. Sometimes they're there to save their lives.
Yeah.
Because I have had a lot of people close to me that was in the system before they got them out the system. But they're no longer here. They're no longer here. So it's hard. You have a lot of single mom raising kids with no fathers. Either they're dead or they're in the system. But we as mothers, we have to stay strong. And we have to be there for our children. You know, it hurts me to see women battering women, women gossiping against women, women don't want to see women. It's you know, it doesn't make sense. We are God's creation. You know, we were created, you know, to endure so much. But then we take that energy that God give us to help each other, but we hurt each other. You know, it takes a village to raise a child. So therefore, when a child is doing something wrong, my kids personally, if y'all see him doing something wrong, I don't say kill him, but knock him side their head and tell him, hey. You know, the other day I sat down, my sister-in-law sent me this poem, and it says, woman. When God created woman, he was working late on the sixth day. An angel came by and asked, why spend so many time on her? The Lord answered, have you seen all the sophistication I have to meet to shape her? She must function all kinds of situations. She must be able to embrace several kids at one time, at the same time. Hugs that can heal anything from a bruised knee to a broken heart. She must do all this with only two hands. She cures herself when sick and can work 18 hours a day. The angel was impressed, and just two hands, impossible. And this is a standard model. The angel came closer and touched the woman. But you have made her so soft, Lord. She's soft, said the Lord. But I have made her strong. You can imagine what she can endure and overcome. Can she think? The angel asked. The Lord answered, not only can she think, she can reason and negotiate. The angel touched her cheeks. Lord, it seems this creation is leaking. You have put too many burdens on her. She's not leaking, she's in tears. The Lord corrected the angel. What is it for? The angel asked. The Lord said, tears are for the way of expressing her grief, her doubt, her love, her loneliness, her suffering, her pain, her pride. This made a big impression on the angel. Lord, you are a genius. You thought of everything. A woman is indeed magnificent and beautiful. Lord said, indeed she is. She has strength that amazes a man. She can handle trouble and carry heavy burdens. She holds happiness, love, and opinion. She smiles when she feels like screaming. She screams when she feels like crying. Cry when heavy and happy, and laugh when afraid. She fights for what she believes in. Her love is unconditional. Her heart is broken when it is next of kin, a friend, a family, someone she doesn't even know dies. But she finds strength to get on with life. The angel asks, so she is perfect being? The Lord replied, no, she's not perfect. She has just one drawback. She often forget what she's worth.
Wow.
Okay? Women, we must respect each other. We are priceless. Our girls and our boys watch what we do and what we say and follow our steps. They watch. And I have learned our kids don't do what we say they do, what they do, what they see we do.
That's true.
So when they do it, because I had a bad temper, I used to cuss and fuss, and then when my daughter did, I'm like, oh my God, that's me. So when I used to beat her, and my mom one day said, why are you beating you? And I couldn't understand it. Till one day I was like just choking her. And then I realized it's just like a button. It's like, that's me. So I had to change me around them to understand that they see what I'm doing. So when you pick up a bottle, you know you're drinking and you're doing all this in front of them, they go, okay, it's okay for mama to do it. It's okay for the parents to do it. We're going to do it. So tonight, this is an open mic for all women. Young, old, young, tall, fat, skinny, whatever it is. All beautiful women. Amen. To express what's in here, what's in your soul, what's hurting you. What makes you, that's why if anybody's to watch, follow me on Facebook, every picture I post up is a smile. I could be broke, can't pay my bills. My daughter, my son, done pissed me off. But I still managed to smile.
Amen.